Hi, thank you so much for joining us. Welcome to our channel. So this week is the first edition in a new episode that we like to call our fashion hot list. We want to show you what's hot and what's not from the world of fashion, lifestyle, music, books, and anything else that we found along the way that we're loving. So let's get stuck in and see what we've got first. So first up, it's pleats, and if we want to be particular about it, knife pleats. We saw loads of this on the catwalk from Amelia Wickstead, Valentino, Balenciaga, some beautiful, beautiful pieces. And then equally on the high street, we featured a couple in our videos recently. So from Zara, we found a beautiful pleated skirt. In Mango, we found a lovely silver one. Whistles always do some gorgeous pleats. And Reese as well have got a beautiful pleated dress in a different tone of the green. So some really gorgeous styles out there of pleats. You can either do a dress, you could do a shirt, you could do a skirt. So I think the trick with this trend is to make sure you toughen it up. You don't want to go pretty on the top half just because you've got a pleated skirt on the bottom. You want it a bit more sharper, a bit of a killer heel, maybe put a bit of leather in there from one of the leather trends. Originals are always the best, and if it's in your budget, I'd say Izumiaki. If that's slightly out of your reach, the high street's got some amazing different items out there with the pleated trend, certainly with lots of silver as well, which personally, I love that look. I think it looks really flattering pretty much on everybody. And as we kind of go into autumn, winter as well, you know, you're thinking more outfits. We probably go out a bit more. So it's outfits for going out at night. Silver's always a winner as well. So have a look online. We've put quite a few suggestions in the description box below of items that we've found that we love that might just give you a bit of inspiration of which way to go with that pleated trend. Handbags. So many beautiful handbags out there for autumn, winter 18. And to be honest, they launch new handbags every day. So I think weekly, we're going to feature our top five favorite handbags that have been launched that week. So let's start with the Chloe quilted Fay bag. Now, obviously a classic from Chloe, reimagined for autumn winter 18 in a quilted leather, which looks absolutely beautiful. So it is obviously an absolutely stunning bag, but with that comes a hefty price tag. It's, we found it on Selfridges at £1,470. Breathe. But it would last you for years. It's an investment, we like to call it. Personally, I don't think handbags ever go out of fashion. The expensive ones I've bought in the past, I still use. I don't really care if they're trendy or not. They're just beautiful pieces of art. So it's an investment, but equally, it's not for everybody spending £1,400 on a bag. But we love it, and it's definitely on our lust after list. So next up is Karen Millen with this metallic silver clutch, which we absolutely love. It's got a nice chain on it, so you can wear it as a crossbody. And obviously using that silver trend for autumn winter 18 that we're seeing lots of. I quite like the fact that, you know, certainly with silver, it's a hard look to pull off if you've gone head to toe in silver. Not gonna look too good on anybody, to be honest, unless you're Kate Moss. So adding a touch of it with a handbag or a shoe or a necklace or something like that, personally, that's how I would do the silver trend for autumn winter 18. So next up, we've got the Anya Hindmarsh chubby clutch, which I love. I love Anya Hindmarsh anyway. I've got a couple of her purses actually. Well, I did have a couple of her purses till someone broke in my car and stole my handbag, which was gorgeous, that came from Matches, with my brand new Anya Hindmarsh purse in the bag. But anyway, that's a whole nother story. So yes, I love this clutch. I think, again, it's a pop of silver, which is lovely for autumn winter. Kind of a different tone. It's a bit more of a creamy kind of silver tone. And I think for dressing up a bit more for the evening, I love that kind of clutch shape. It's quite boxy, but it looks quite elegant as well at the same time. And it's obviously got the gold claspings and that kind of thing. And just to give you an option as well, it's got a gold chain inside so you can wear it as a crossbody, which I thought was really nice. So yeah, we love the Anya Hindmarsh bags, but particularly this one for this autumn winter, we think is spot on. Okay, so another big trend for autumn winter 18 is the acrylic tortoise shell. So you can go with a handbag, you can go with earrings, you can go with a necklace. Personally, for me, it isn't my favorite trend. However, I did find this bag on Mango and I think it's the perfect way to introduce a little bit of this trend for autumn winter 18. So it's kind of tortoise shell, it's acrylic, it's got sort of the metal clasps, and I think for the price as well, good value for money to be able to have a sprinkling of that trend. And it does look quite classy, as opposed to some of the others in that particular trend can tend to look a little bit cheap. So I think Mango have done a good job at that one. I really like it. So last but not least, of course, we're back to other stories, which we seem to be humongous fans of at the moment. But I really, really love their handbags. And to be honest, when I was trying to choose my favorite for this week, I could have put about 5 in just from other stories. Tough decision, this would be my favorite this week, I think. Simply because it's so practical. I'd probably use this an awful lot. Really good value for money. Obviously they're premium leather. Yeah, really, really love this. And I think it would pretty much go with everything for autumn winter 18. Kind of makes me think it's got a bit of a 70s vibe to it. So again, just in keeping, but to be honest with you, next autumn winter, I don't think this bag's ever gonna look out of fashion. So probably a good investment buy. So next up would be my favorite book ever, which is the Grace Coddington autobiography, simply called Grace. Now, it's not new, but it's definitely worth a mention in this week's hot list, because if you haven't read it yet, you definitely should. She's one of my icons, actually. She was a fashion model, she's Welsh, and did incredibly well shooting with all the top photographers when she was young. Then she had a car accident and had to have plastic surgery on her eyelid. So a terrible car accident. Then she went on, 2 years later, worked for Vogue, British Vogue. And after a while, I think maybe 19 years at British Vogue, went over to America, worked with Calvin Klein, and eventually ended up as Anna Wintour's right-hand woman, as creative director on the shoots with American Vogue. Now she's done the most amazing fashion stories I think I've ever seen. I remember as I grew up, I used to be obsessed with collecting Vogue every month from a really young age actually, which is quite strange to be into probably an older magazine. But I loved looking at her fashion stories. They were so creative and so like a magical wonderland world. The things that she did in photo shoots, you always almost could tell always that it was a Grace Coddington fashion story without even having to read her name on it. So the autobiography basically tells the story of her life, her early life as a model, the car accident, and then talks us through the meeting all these different fashion designers and the story of how she came up with these shoots. And it's fascinating. If you're into fashion, I think you will love it. I absolutely love it. It's one of my favorite books ever. So I would highly, highly recommend giving that one a read. So prairie dresses, obviously we've been talking about them lots in our videos the last couple of weeks. It's a huge trend for autumn winter 18. I personally love the trend. It suits my kind of boho vibes that I wear a lot of. And also we've been seeing a lot of monochrome prairie dresses, which I thought was a nice twist on the trend really, just to kind of toughen the look up a little bit. You shouldn't really go too fussy anywhere else. If you're wearing a prairie dress, obviously there's lots of frills and ruffles, and a lot of the time there's lots of florals. So I'd keep it really simple everywhere else. So maybe some nice flat boots or even some loafers. If you're gonna wear some heels with it, I'd maybe add a little pop sock. I quite like that with long dresses, pop sock, and some sandals. So we've linked in the description below some of our favorites that we found and kind of given you a bit of a mixture of price points. So depending on your budget, there's something for everybody in the prairie trend. And love to hear from you. Love to know where you found some really nice prairie dresses. For us, it was sort of Topshop, Rixo. Found a couple on Selfridges actually, of different dresses. Free People have got some really nice ones as well. So worth having a good Google about, and also check the description below and see what you think to the ones we selected as well. So wide leg trousers, I love, definitely seeing loads of that for autumn winter 18. Particularly loving them in the kind of wool. I think that mixture of textures, particularly through winter, is a nice look. So if you've got a wool trouser, maybe add a silk shirt, and particularly with loafers as well. I like to oversize things, as you probably gathered from our videos. I found a really lovely pair in Other Stories the other day when I popped to London, and they're white, which is totally not practical, but they're so lovely. They're like a wool blend, really high-waisted, really baggy around, probably quite long actually. I'm nearly 5'8" and they were long on me. but although they would probably scuff a little bit on the hem, I think with loafers, I love that kind of, it sort of all gathers around your foot. I think that's a really chic look. And either pair it with, you know, a nice sweater, keep it quite simple on the top, maybe tighter on the top, because obviously you've got so much width going on the bottom half of you. So keep it quite tight on the top, either with a sweater, nice roll neck, or a silk shirt to kind of bring in that trend as well. So have a look in the description, see what you think to the different styles that we found, and let me know if you like them. On our hot list are loafers. We love loafers. They are so comfy, and to be honest, I will suffer for my fashion. I will wear ridiculous heels, but if something's on trend and it's really comfortable, I'm definitely gonna jump on the bandwagon with that one. So first up, I would say Todd's, the original and still probably the best for doing loafers. They are ridiculously comfy. I don't think I've ever put a shoe on as comfortable as wearing a pair of Todd's. They're not the cheapest, but so worth it. Really, really last. The quality is incredible. And as I said, they are so comfy. I think I'd pay good money for that for my poor feet. I also found a really gorgeous pair on Salvatore Ferragamo. Really love those. Again, a bit more pricey. On the cheaper end of the scale, we found some gorgeous ones in New Look. New Look are brilliant for shoes. They've really got that spot on and probably have done for a good few years now. Also, other stories. I just bought some the other day. Again, they're leather is just beautiful, so when it comes to shoes, they've got that really sorted, and love this particular style. I think it's a really classy look, wear with that kind of really wide leg sort of palazzo pant that's really sort of slouchy, just with a pair of loafers. I think is a really nice look. The loafers are the kind of thing that you could probably put with any outfit, to be honest. It's just particularly nice for this autumn winter, and again for us, particularly in black, I much prefer them in black. Maybe in an animal print, I quite like that as well. But again, it's about finding the right tone of animal print and not looking too glam. I did get some the other day actually in animal print, and my son looked at me in horror and said, "What is that on your feet? They look disgusting." So it is about getting it right and not necessarily taking fashion advice from your 13-year-old son. But you know, it was probably a valid point, and I think they might get back to the shop. So anyway, selection in the description again below. Bit of a few different price points there, so you can have a little browse as well. So next up is a movie that I watched the other night actually. It's called American Animals, and if you haven't already seen it, you definitely should. I loved this film. So it's about four young guys. They're at university, I think in Transylvania. Not much happens in their town. It's really boring, and they're all kind of questioning. It's a bit more like a coming of age thing. They're questioning, what are we doing in life? It's a true story. Not just based on a true story, they actually kind of highlight the fact that this is actually what happened, which makes it even more ridiculous in a way. So they discover in the university that there's this book in the library, and it's one of the most rare books in the world. So it's worth millions and millions and millions of pounds. And they decide to hatch a plan to steal it. But as the story goes on, and without ruining it for you, it all goes really pear-shaped. And it's funny because it's just so, like, you can imagine your 17-year-old self, not that I would ever steal a book like that, but the stupid things you do and the stupid way you think about things and don't kind of take into consideration what might happen if I do this. So yeah, I loved the film. I laughed all the way through. It was really nicely shot actually. The cinematography was cool. I would highly recommend watching that when you get a moment and you want to have a bit of a chill. Take yourself away and probably learn that stealing one of the most rare books in the world is never a good idea. So on our hot list for album of the week definitely goes to Marabou State for their new album, Kingdoms in Colour. Love, 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 love Marabou State since they brought out their first album, Portraits, I think in 2016. The track on their Steel is just still to this day one of my favourites. So beautiful, kind of like that hauntingly beautiful kind of music. Favourite tracks on the album, I would say Beginner's Luck, Veil, I think is beautiful, kind of along those similar lines as Steel, and Kingdom is pretty cool as well. It's nice to see a British electronic duo doing so well, so definitely championing them, and I think you will love this album. It's beautiful. So that's it, our first ever fashion and lifestyle hot list is complete. I do hope you like it. Yes, a bit of a curated list of our favourite bits that we found. We would like to keep filming these, so hopefully you've enjoyed this episode. Do let us know in the comments section what you thought, and hopefully we've given you a bit of inspiration of some of the ways to wear different trends and some of the things we found online at the moment to buy. Don't forget to find us on Instagram at Fashion and Style Edit, and there's also links on YouTube where you can find our blog, etc., where we waffle about various other things to do with fashion as well. Thanks ever so much. See you later.